welcome everybody. My name is Simon from SwingdanceUK and this is my 30-day challenge, day number 20. Can't believe it, we're two-thirds of the way through. We have got some wonderful exercises coming up for you in a second. I just want to thank you for being here. Remember, make sure your space is clear. Pick your own pace. Don't kill yourself if you don't need to, or maybe go a little bit harder if you want to. But know what feels right for your body. We're going to start, as ever, with a breathing exercise. And this is to supercharge our mind, our body, our spirit. We're just going to take some classic deep breaths. We're going to fill our body with oxygen. We're going to expand the lungs. We're going to breathe into the belly. But what I want you to do is I want you to either focus on one spot and focus on one spot. Just relax the eyes and keep your attention there. Or possibly you might even want to close your eyes, and that's fine too. So I'm going to focus today on one spot. So if I look like I'm staring, that's why. We're going to take a big breath in and a big breath out, but slow, controlled, not forced. And we breathe in. And out. Bring your awareness to the breath as you breathe in. And breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Picture the breath as you go, breathe in. Breathe out. One more time, breathe in. And out. And now you're feeling supercharged. We're ready for our thought of the day. Something that I've been thinking about recently is my role. Now, when I talk about my role, as a dancer, I've often been involved in shows, many of which I've produced, and I've taken on the role of a director, of the choreographer, of the dancer, of the lighting and technical expert, of the stage manager. And I've had all these different roles, and no matter how good you are, my best performances always come when I only have two, one or two of those roles. In terms of performing, you need to be able to focus on that job that you're doing. So I found that when I have other people doing those roles, it produces a much better performance from me. So how can we apply that to our everyday life? And I think about the roles I have as a solopreneur. I have to do the accounts, I have to do the marketing, I have to look after the office, I have to do the selling, I have to do the product. You have to do everything. And that can be quite hard to try and do everything, especially all at the same time, because you put your energies, your mind goes somewhere, it's like multitasking, and your focus is there, and then to switch focus can be quite hard. So what I've found has been working for me is to actually try and focus on one role at a time. So I'm trying to separate and be able to be in a position of, if it's marketing, of focusing on the marketing, if it's dancing, of focusing on the dancing. And I think you need to separate those different roles to really get the best out of you. I think multitasking is tough and doesn't really work. That's the thought for the day. Let me know what you think. Maybe you have a different opinion. Maybe you're a multitasker and you can do 10 things at once and you think you do them all the better for it. Let me know. Time to warm up. And this time is going to be to Fats Waller and my very good friend, the milkman.
My milkman said, and I too much sleep, he doesn't like the now my keep. He suggests that you should marry me. Our friend, my birthday friend,
It's going to be a nice, cool, laid-back, easy routine to fit the music. We're going to start with a fall off the log, nice and relaxed, a fall off the log, a shorty George. Let me turn around and show you. We kick the right foot on eight, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So we're going to kick the right foot, step behind, to the side, cross in front. Kick, behind, side, front. Kick, behind, side, front on the right foot. We're gonna kick the left, kick and right, left, right. So it's gonna be kick and quick, quick, slow. So the rhythm, kick and quick, quick, slow. I call that the feet. Kick the left together, right, on the left foot, and then step right, left, right, hold. From the tippity top, a five, six, seven. A one. Eight, one, two, three, four, and five, six, seven, hold eight. Then we're going to do the rhythm. Quick, quick, slow, a quick, quick, slow, with a shorty George. A quick, quick, slow, and a quick, quick, slow. So this is knees bent, weight on the toes, a quick, quick, slow, and a quick, quick, slow. We're on the tip of the top, we'll add it on the end. Five, six, a five, six, seven. Eight, one, two, three, five, six, seven. A one, two, three, four, a five, six, seven. A one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. From here, a rock step, hold and turn around. Back on the left foot, we cross behind, rock, replace onto the right. We're going to take our left foot and cross it in front. At the same time, we're going to move the right foot. So we get a shuffle, right, left, right. Now, this is called a heel and toe turn, because I push off the heel of the front foot, the toe of the back foot. I look over my right shoulder. I turn, 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 turn. And as I get near the end, bring the feet together. Rock, step, hold, and turn around. I'm going to finish with the weight on my left foot, because I know what's coming next. So from the Shorty Georges, kick and quick, quick, slow. Another quick, quick, slow, and a quick, quick, slow. Back rock, cross, look over the right shoulder, you turn around, and at the end, bring the feet together, step onto the left foot. From here, we go a boogie drop, and a boogie drop. We go tap, tap, drop, tap, tap, drop. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. We're going to turn and we're going to go up with the hips and back and up and back and up and back and up and back. So from the boogie drop, turn up. The hips come forward, I'm pushing over my front foot, the arms come up. I push the hips back and I sit on that back leg. And up, and back, and up, and back. One, two, three, four, five, six, repeat. A two, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Let's put that together from the boogie drops. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four. Five, six, seven, two, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Kick the right foot. And here we're gonna do a step I love, a fall off the log with a hesitation. Eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Eight, one, two, three, four, hold five, six, seven. I'll fall off the log with a hesitation. We kick the right foot. Eight, one, behind, side, step, push and hold. So it goes, eight, one, two, three, four, just stop there. Five, six, seven, kick, behind, side, side, hold, down, out. Eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. From here, we go into a heel and toe and a tick-tock. So from here, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Well, we can do it fast. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Whatever inspires you, half time or full time. The main thing is, we go on the heel of one foot and the toe of the other, and reverse and reverse and reverse. We have some arms. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, hold, turn around. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, kick. One, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Start again. Perfect. Then let's do it with music.
My hurry, good friend, the mailman's
everyone. From the top. Time for some stretching. We are going to start with the classic stand on one leg, pick the other leg up and pull in the knee and tuck and lift and hold. Oh, feel that stretch. Make sure you balance, bend the supporting leg and relax. Pick up the other leg first, balance, grab hold, pick it up a little higher and hold it there. We balance and we tall. Imagine there's a cord pulling from the middle of your head, pulling up nice and tall. Keep the tummy lifted, bend the supporting leg. Try and get your balance and relax. One more time. I'd love to hear from some of you how you're getting on with these stretches and the warm-ups that we do, if you find them easy or difficult. If you want them more challenging, let me know. Or maybe we could do another cycle. Or maybe you want the moves broken down a little bit more. And pause. So yeah, do comment, and maybe you think this would be useful for a friend, so you can send it to them. Now, we're going to do the rotation. I'm going to place the hands firmly on my back with a little pressure. I'm then going to look with my chin down over my shoulder, and then I'm going to rotate my hip, but try not to turn the toes, yeah? So I'm just going to go head, and hip, and relax. Head, and torso, and relax. Notice my knees are soft, they're not locked. I turn my head, looking down slightly, look over, and relax. Turn the head, look over the shoulder, and relax. One more time. Head, torso, relax, head, torso, and relax. We're going to do a standing cat-cow stretch. So we're going to place the hands on the knees and we're going to round the back and make it as rounded as you can. And then we're gonna arch forward, looking up, pushing the hips back and the chest forward. And then we're gonna round the back. Oh, for the stretch, and looking forward. These are some of the exercises I like to do every morning, whenever I've got a spare few minutes, just to stretch, bend the knees, make sure they bend, and push back. This is a standing cat-cow. And forward. I've been dancing for over 30 years now, and luckily I'm still dancing, so I must be doing something right. And looking forward, and back. And relax. We're now going to do the hamstring scoop. So we sit back on one leg. We did an exercise which was more static, but this one, we lift the hands up, we bring them down, we flow through, and we scoop. We bring the hands down, we push the hips back, we flow and scoop. Bring the hands down, push hips back, and scoop, and down, and scoop. This time we're going to dig the heel into the floor so the toe is lifted. We go down and scoop. And we push the hips back, sit down, keep the head forward and scoop. Let's try the other side. First with a flat foot, make sure the feet are fairly in line. You push the hips back. You go down and you scoop up. Bring the arms down, looking straight ahead. Don't crick the neck, but just looking forward and down and scoop and down and scoop. Dig the heel into the floor. One more time. Go down and scoop. Push back, hips back, and scoop. So I hope you enjoyed today. We kept it nice and easy, nothing too stressful, I hope. I hope you enjoyed the breathing and a little bit of stretching at the end, and of course the dancing. Do let me know how you're getting on. Let me know some comments if the routines are too fast, too slow, too easy, too hard. It's great to hear from you. I need that feedback to get an understanding of how we're all doing. It's great to share this with everybody. I know we've got people doing this from all across the world, and it's a wonderful thing really that we're able to do that. So if you're from across the world, because I live in the UK, let me know where you're from. It'd be great to hear from you, and we will see you tomorrow on day 21. Thank you.